and said, "Dad, would you come over and sit with the boys?" And I said, "Sure." I went over there and I sat down on the sofa. Jordan left. And the three-year-old, Jace, he comes up and he has his Mickey Mouse in one arm and he has his blanket in the other. He starts crawling up in my lap and he got about eye level with me. Listen, he got about eye level with me, looked me right in the eyes and says, "Pa," he said, "I'm Pa's boy."
Aww.
I said, "You can have my truck." Just like that. Just like that, I needed a new truck. But those are some neat changes. Something that has been, but we've become aware of, I think, because of the age we're living in, 24-hour news, we've become aware of a, I'm not going to say a generation, but a group of people that don't appreciate the freedom that we have here in the United States of America. And they certainly have no appreciation for our veterans. So I want to say right now, on behalf of the Lefebvre Quartet, to all of our veterans here, thank you. We love you. We sang at a Bible conference not too long ago. The pastor said that it's one of the greatest tragedies in America is the church walking down the aisle of compromise and complacency. Think about it. Folks, if there was ever a time the church needs to stand for what is holy and stand for what is right, now's the time for the church to arise and tell the world that Jesus is the answer. If you believe that, say amen.
We've sat silent for too long while the darkness ever strong casts a shadow on this land. We're the children of the light. We have hope that's burning bright. We weren't made to cower. We were made to stand. Oh,